That's carried. Thank you. Council, I have checked. Oh, sorry, take this. I need to sign it. Council, I have checked with the clerk, and as you know, there were a number of statements made at the previous council meeting, and I have asked to rise on a point of personal privilege. So I'm handing the chair to Councillor Plushy because you're here, and so if the chair would accept that, then I would like to make a statement as a point of personal privilege. Thank you very much. I'm now, Councillor Plushy is now in the chair. Council, on Wednesday, March 26th, the previous council meeting, I was absent. As you are all made aware, the reason for the absence was I was at the hospital. My husband was undergoing open heart surgery that day. I want to first thank the good people of Brampton for the outpouring of support and prayers for John's recovery. We are grateful for your kind. Brampton is a family community, and Brampton understands that family matters above all else. I was so appalled and disgusted with the underhanded, self-serving tactics of certain members of council displayed at the last council meeting to try and score political points during my absence while I am at the hospital with my husband is distasteful and beneath the threshold of common decency and respect you expect from your colleagues, let alone your adversaries. I was equally disgusted by the shameless timing of the barrage of questions and accusations thrown at me by a certain reporter at the Toronto Star while at the hospital with my family. You should be ashamed of yourself for your actions, which are not befitting of a qualified journalist. I am taking this time to tell you enough is enough. The mayor is now fighting back.
Away.
There is.
Excuse me, please. Thank you. Go ahead.
The mayor is now fighting back. There is no scandal in Brampton. All budgets are approved by council. There is a process. Council approved the mayor's advocacy role at FCM and an international trade agenda. Council approved the salaries for the mayor and for the council. I will remain focused on my job as your mayor and will seek decorum in this chamber. Enough is enough. I am always accountable. The public deserves the truth because the truth matters and facts count. Countless people have urged me over many months to fight back. I have led and served this council as an elected official for almost 24 years. During this time, I have worked tirelessly championing this great city wherever I am and serving you, the taxpayers, with the utmost integrity, dedication, and determination. This unwavering commitment to protect your interests and serve you with honesty, full transparency, and respect was recognized by you as you elected and re-elected me to serve as your mayor four times. I am proud of our collective achievements. We have grown from a small town to a booming city, growing stronger by the day, attracting talent from around the world. You have chosen Brampton to call home and to do business. Families and business succeed here. I applaud our city staff for their contributions and delivering on Brampton Council's priorities and decisions. The story of our success is profound. Our success indicates our spirit of unity, teamwork, determination to be the best we could be. However, over the past several months, there has been a concerted effort by a group of my own colleagues, councillors you have elected, in conjunction with the Toronto Star, to create a smear campaign of the name of our city, Brampton, all with the goal of actually smearing my name. From the most recent ridiculous statements about missing money relating to capital projects to the almost weekly attacks to the credibility of myself as mayor. I am speaking right here, right now, because enough is enough. You will no longer you will no longer derail Brampton's reputation or besmirch the reputation of this great city. I will not sit quiet a moment longer. Yes, I am known for taking the high road. I have not pushed back. I have not spoken until now. The gloves are off. I will fight for this city. I will fight to protect our reputation. I am and will fight for the good people of Brampton and put an end to this sideshow. Folks, I want to make one thing absolutely clear to you. There is no scandal. Let me say it three times. There is no scandal in Brampton. There is no scandal in Brampton. There is the scandalous behavior of a handful of publicly elected councillors tarnishing Brampton's reputation for their own attempted political gain. For months, some members of council have tried to position my work, that of our city staff and other members of council, in an effort to manufacture stories that have upset and misled the residents to believe there is a scandal brewing. I've been ridiculed and wrongly characterized by the Toronto Star as a mayor who wastes your tax dollars on lavish expenses, that I'm feeling entitled to my entitlement, so to speak. Numerous stories filled with bias, half-truths, and limiting the context for reasonable people to get the whole story. Well, let's talk about my expenses and the mayor's council-approved budget, which has not been exceeded year over year. You see, the beauty of our governance structure as municipalities under a democracy is that decisions made are formed through consensus, meaning no one councillor or the mayor has the power to veto the will or the majority of council on any decision. A mayor of any city carries equal weight as his or her own council colleagues. That vote represents one vote and one vote only. It is our duty as elected officials to listen to the taxpayers, heed the advice of city staff, and come to a decision that best reflects what we collectively feel serves the best interests of taxpayers. So let's bring this closer to home. These select councillors who've been running around to the media to offer their comments of shock and dismay over my spending failed to mention that every single budget that has been introduced since I've been elected as mayor has been approved by all members of council. I've stayed within these approved budgets while getting things done. I repeat, every single budget that has been introduced since I've been elected as mayor has been approved by all members of council, which begs the question to those councillors who are now protesting. Were you not paying attention when you voted over the past 14 years, or are you conveniently forgetting what you did in an attempt to score political points now? It can only be one of the two. The Toronto Star and some of my council colleagues can try and fool you by manufacturing these crises, but the fact of the matter is that we have a process that dictates these budgets, and nothing here is scandalous. The estimates for expenses like travel or office expenses are not created at will. They are developed in conjunction with experienced city staff who take a look at what our goals are as a city to bring results for taxpayers. Reports are presented to council, which we collectively approve or question or reject. I do not unilaterally approve my own budgets. Council does so collectively. My budgets have been approved with the support of Councillor Elaine Moore, Councillor John Sprovieri, Councillor John Sanderson, all who have lately been expressing shock and dismay as if they had no clue where these budgets came from. Again, I ask you, councillors, were you not paying attention for the past 14 years and blindly voting without representing the interests of your taxpayers? A great example of how things have been recklessly mischaracterized by some of the council colleagues is to piggyback on the Toronto Star, a manufactured story, is your decision, your vote for my participation on the board of SCM, and your decision to have government relations staff in my office also participate. Full council approval, full council support. Yes, council approved the mayor's participation. Council knows there's travel involved. Truth matters. Results count. Over the 6 years reported in the Toronto Star, records show there was an average of $30,000 per year appropriated to FCM council-approved budget for the mayor and staff-approved participation. As the result, not included in the Star story because it does not suit their narrative. According to our CAO, John Corbett, the city of Brampton has received $578 million through this important advocacy. $578 million. As mayor, I have seen the transformation of our local economies across municipalities in Canada. No longer is there the same robust manufacturing sector as there once was that brought money into the cities to offset property tax hikes. With the loss of those traditional sources of revenue, with higher infrastructure costs and government downloading, we have two choices. Either continue to dig deeper into the pockets of taxpayers or minimize that by seeking out funding partnerships from other levels of government. Brampton invested $180,000 over 6 years, $30,000 a year, to bring a result of $578 million. Truth matters and results count. We live in a globally competitive environment. We're competing with neighboring municipalities for business opportunities, jobs, jobs, and jobs, and investment. Our success means we ultimately see more opportunities for our citizens, more jobs, and a stronger economy that helps lower the tax burden on residents. This council approved an international investment strategy for this term. My travels to China, India, and the Philippines, each individually approved by all council, in a report to council, open, public, and transparent, are a reality of our times. One cannot attract investments to our city, as one of my colleagues has suggested, by being a stay-at-home mayor. We must be aggressive. We must show at the forefront our strengths in Brampton, our education, skilled labor, strong location, exceptional quality of life, our diversity to attract new investments from around the world, and Brampton is succeeding. Following each councilor-approved mission, a summary report complete with analysis is put to council. Every time, unanimously approved without questions. So I ask you, the taxpayers, is it reasonable to spend budgets approved by council to advocate for funding to relieve property taxes? Is it reasonable to spend budgets approved by council to travel internationally and put Brampton on the world stage and compete strongly for the next generation of investments in Canada, the next generation of jobs, and promote our local business community on the world stage? This is to lessen the tax burden on you. Is that reckless entitlement or a demonstration of strong leadership? Now let's move to my office budget. The Toronto Star, with the assistance of some councillors, have reported that I have spent $186,000 over the past 3 years and then duplicated these numbers with headlines of me or my staff spending hundreds of thousands of dollars on credit cards, characterizing my spending as out of control. Again, every single budget, year after year, for the past 14 years, has been approved by the majority or a majority of council, not by me on my own, folks. Budgets approved by council, not exceeded. Yes, corporate credit cards are used. That provides a paper trail and accountability, transparency of where every dollar was spent. So when some of you councillors pick up the phone and speak to your partner and favorite reporter at the Star and sensationalize your narrative, do you forget that you once believed these budgets were reasonable? Or do you forget to mention that over 70% of the office expenses went directly to support youth, seniors, and community groups in the city under the council-approved budget line, marketing, advertising, and promotion? And to this media-hungry pack of councillors, along with their favorite non-biased reporter, why create an air of unsubstantiated suspicion and speculation about credit card expenses while we all collectively and unanimously approved a forensic audit to look at all our expenses? And to the Star, did you overlook office expenses such as Councillor Moore's self-promotion, garden appreciation, lawn signs during non-election years, or Councillor Callahan's personal expenses for his Law Society lawyer's dues and continuing legal education requirements, or Councillor Sprovieri's home alarm system? You called these reasonable on your recent TV show just two nights ago. Never let the truth get in the way of trying to score a few political points and trying to sell papers, right? Why this sort of hypocrisy and journalism goes on and on. Why? Shame on you.
Shame on you. There will be questions.
Full disclosure is important. There will be mistakes. I commit to the residents of this city that strict new controls are being installed. I insist on it. We can always do better. I will review and re-review every expense practice in my office to ensure value for money and demand tougher scrutiny. I will continue to do the job I'm elected to do to serve the people of Brampton, not the Toronto Star. Therefore, I will not be responding further to the ongoing questions and queries on a daily basis by the Toronto Star to feed into their narrative of manufacturing a crisis that only they and a few self-serving councillors want to portray. It simply does not exist. Hours of staff time in many departments trying their best to provide accurate responses only to be half reported or ignored by the Star. Did you know that the City of Brampton has had to retain a lawyer, taxpayer expense, to push back the bias and incomplete reporting of the Star? Last week, the city had to use taxpayers' money to set the record straight in a paid ad to correct the outrageous statements of these same councillors. 2 weeks ago, the Brampton Board of Trade, our Brampton Board of Trade, sent a letter to the Star urging them to discontinue this reputational harm to our city. Lastly, I want to address the issue of my salary head on. You, council, approve my salary. You, council, approve your salary. You have unquestionably approved the mayor and councillor's salary every time the matter is before council. Most recently, spring 2013 and December 11, 2013. You know an arm's length compensation committee recommends a salary structure. You know the salaries formula is designed to set salaries for all members of this council each term with incremental adjustments over a 10-year period, beginning in 2006. You approved the salary formula and the chart displaying what the salary for the mayor and council is for every single year, including this one and last one. The Toronto Star calls the mayor out in 2012. Note they're now being specific to 2012 because their story cannot be said for 2001, 2002, 2003, and so on, nor for 2013. Sam Graywall knows he's wrong. You know he's wrong. Councillor Moore and Councillor Sanderson, Councillor Spravere, did you not read the report or hear the presentation from the chair of the Compensation Committee, not me, but the chair, on December 11, 2013, during the annual budget presentation in this chamber? That afternoon, even the Star headline, quote, Brampton Mayor Susan Fennell, actually ninth highest paid mayor in Canada, councillors told. In 2012, I was in fact the ninth highest paid mayor, and not the highest for that 1 year. Last week, councillors again complained about the mayor's salary that they approved for the mayor. I didn't compromise the decision of this council to reset the salary you assigned to the mayor. I did not reopen the compensation decision of this council. No, I listened to many residents and I reviewed the matter and took action to simply not accept the mayor's salary assigned by this council. Yes, I reduced what I was entitled to by this council because I believe it was the right thing to do. Why didn't I not openly bring this to your attention so you could mock and characterize it as a stunt? No, I simply listened to the public, reviewed the council decision entitlement, and took action. I reduced my entitled salary. I cut it 15%. To speculate motive when I'm absent is disgraceful. A decision I made 6 months ago could have waited one council meeting for your brave questions in my absence. Ladies and gentlemen, as I mentioned earlier, I have remained focused on the job I'm elected to do, lead Brampton to a brighter future, a future that is ours to seize together. Yet to the countless residents who have contacted me, expressing frustration and seeing through shameful behavior of certain councillors and telling me the mayor needs to fight back. I've heard your words. Taking the high road just doesn't cut it, you've said to me. When the city's reputation, my integrity, my respect for taxpayers begins to get questioned unfairly in order to destroy my reputation and Brampton's brand, I'm standing up, the gloves are off, and I'm fighting back. Because the truth matters and facts count. While some of my council colleagues are busy campaigning for political points under the guise of protecting taxpayers, all the while collecting a taxpayer-paid paycheck from you, I'm leading by action. My certain colleagues, while they continued to hurl accusations against me just to grab a good headline or two, I took action to improve things. I cut the expenses in the office of the mayor. I took a self-imposed pay cut in response to what I heard from taxpayers without any political fanfare or grandstanding. My reward? A scolding from the city's usual detractors on council, and of course, the star for my doing the right thing. If it was wrong, it would not have been permitted by city staff. I supported the forensic audit to provide for better clarity on all members of council's expenses, including my own. But actions speak louder than words, truth matters, and facts count. Can more be done to improve how we spend, track, and file our expenses? Absolutely. There's always room for improvement. It's time for certain members of this council to stop campaigning for a new mayor in this chamber while collecting a paycheck from taxpayers. Do the job you're elected to do. Let's work together to be part of building this city, not the obstacle. When the city you live in, raise a family in, spend time with friends in, becomes the target of a vicious, calculated attack for personal political gain, Susan Fennell will stand up and fight back. To Mr. Cook and the Toronto Star, I publicly and respectfully request that you review the standard of journalism that is representing your name here in Brampton. I welcome the opportunity to sit down and share my views on the success of Brampton, which you seldom, if ever, print. I have been receptive to constructive criticism my entire political career, and I'm always keen on improving where we need to improve. Acknowledging this and taking action rather than digging in my heels and declaring all is just fine is a reflection of strong leadership, and I pride myself on serving the good people of this city with that standard of confidence and humility. Let's get back on track, shall we, and move our great city forward. It's time to build on our strengths of being a terrific family community, a youth-friendly community, a city with an incredible transit system for seniors. Ride for $1, a city where business succeeds. There is more we can achieve collectively rather than divided. It's time we pound the doors of the province and finally bring home a university in closing. I want to reiterate that I am a very proud mayor. I will continue to work with the highest of respect for taxpayers. And finally, I thank council for this opportunity today to set the record straight.
Thank you, Mayor. I see one name on the board, but when I checked with the clerk, and this was back onto the meeting, please. And I will pass it back to the mayor.